In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can have some advanced border radius for different elements on our web page. So let me first show you how it's going to look. So we will be using the Plus Addons for Gutenberg, and with this we will have an option for advanced border radius. And using this, we will be able to create some amazing looking custom shapes and border radius, which will make our web elements look something like this. Or maybe we can create elements like this one. And we can also give a unique custom look for our social media icons as well. Or maybe you can give custom shapes to your images, which will look something like this. Or maybe this one. So let's go ahead and dive in our WordPress backend and see how we can add these kind of custom border radius and shapes to various elements on our website. So if that sounds interesting and you also want to give your web elements a unique look with these advanced borders, then hop in and I'll show you everything step by step. My name is Ankit Sharma from the team Posimyth, and if you want to deep dive in the world of WordPress using Gutenberg, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. And now we are on this page where we have, in case one, we will use this info box. And in the case two, we will add these custom border radius to our images. So here we have the info box, and normally they are in square shape. But if we click on any of these boxes, here in the advanced section, we can go to borders and maybe then we can assign a solid border here. And just to give it a highlight, let's make it black. And with the border width, let's add 3 pixel. And with the border radius, we can play around with, let's say, 10 pixel border radius all around. So here we have the rounded borders. Or maybe we can unlink these values and just play around with different values for maybe right or left. But with this, we are limited only to 4 values, that is top, right, bottom and left. So whatever value of radius we enter here, that will reflect here. But now let's go ahead and take this to the next level and see what else we can do. So first, let's get rid of this border radius from here. And now, in order to add some advanced border radius to this, we will close it from here, and then we will go to plus extras. And here you will find advanced border radius option. Let's click on this. And here we have option for selected area, which is right now set on background. We can choose custom as well. And then enter a unique class for that element, which we will take a look in just a few minutes. So first, let's keep it on background. And here we can choose some predefined layouts for our shape that we want to give to this info box. So this is how it's going to look. And now in the same way, if you mouse over on this info box, it does nothing. But if we click on this hover option here, we can assign a different shape to this. Let's say this one. And now if you mouse over on this info box, you can see that it's changing its shape. And once we have assigned the layout for normal as well as hover, we can close this. And we go in spacing and then add a little bit of extra padding here. So this will make our content a bit visible. And in the same way, we can add any advanced border radius to this info box as well. Now let's scroll down a little bit. And here we have case number 2. Now here we have this single image. And if we go in the advanced section, once again, we have normal border. We can give a border color and then we can add a border width and border radius as well. So this is how it's going to look. Now, in order to give advanced border radius to our images, we need the class for that particular image. So for that, let's open this page in the front end. And for this image, let's go ahead and click on Inspect Element. And here is the class. We have hover underscore img. So let's copy this class from here. Let's close this box. And now if we select this image and go to advanced and go to plus extras, here we have the advanced border radius. Let's open this. And here selected area instead of background. This time we need to select custom. So for images, we need to enter the unique class. So let's enter it here. And make sure you add the dot sign or the period sign before the class name. And as soon as you do that, you will see that the advanced border layout is applied here. So here you can see our image is changing the shape. And in order to add the advanced border radius for this image as well, we again need to inspect this image and see the class name. Again, we need to go to advanced and then click on plus extras. We go to advanced border radius and we'll choose custom. And again, we have the class hover underscore image added here. And now we can choose our custom shape. And in the same way, we can also define the layout of this advanced border for the hover as well. So let's choose this one. So you can see on hover, it's changing the shape of this image. The interesting part. Here we have predefined layouts for this advanced border radius. If you want, you can give your custom shape as well. So for that, we need to choose custom from here and then enter the custom border radius values. And how we can define that? Let's scroll down a little bit. And here is a link that you can use. So let's open that in a new tab. And here you can define your fancy border radius. So let's say we create our custom shape here, something like this. And once you are done, all you have to do is copy the border radius from here and come back here and then enter the custom value here in this box. And now you can see we have the custom shape here. And once again, we can do the same for hover as well. Or maybe we can choose the predefined layout. So now we have a custom advanced border radius for this image here. If we update this page and let's refresh our front end. So here you can see for this info box, we have our custom shape added here and it changes the border radius on the mouse over as well. And below this, we have the same advanced border for our images as well. So this is how easy it is with the Plus add-ons for Gutenberg to create some advanced looking borders for various elements on your website. If you like this video, then make sure you hit the like button. And if you want to watch more videos like this and learn how you can create some amazing stuff using the Plus add-on, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. So that's it for this one, and I'll see you in the next one.